And chess.com is here with the co-leader of the 2019 U.S. Championship, Grandmaster Lanier Dominguez. I would say that the first U.S. Championship you've played in is going pretty well so far. What would you say?
Yeah, I mean, it's going pretty well, obviously. I feel pretty good. Like, from the beginning, I felt that I was getting some good positions, and I was doing well in the middle game. I was seeing some moves, and I feel good. I mean, I obviously have some chances to get the title, but I will just take it game by game, and I will do my best.
And today's a game against Grandmaster Sam Sevian, who's also having a good tournament. At what point did you realize you were essentially playing for two results and you couldn't possibly lose and you were going to be the one to push?
Yeah, well, after we traded queens on e6, then I thought I'm not losing for sure. But I actually thought that it was very, very close to being a complete draw. And then I realized I have some very small chances, so I kept on playing. And then he probably wasn't too precise. I think after he allowed me to play this rook g8, rook g5 idea, he was, I mean, his position became a bit more unpleasant, and in practice he couldn't find a defense.
And a lot has been made about the fact you haven't played a classical game in about 2.5 years due to your FIDE transfer. Is there any way to simulate a classical game? I mean, did you play any 3 or 4 hour games, or does that an atmosphere not really exist when you're playing a training game?
I wanted to play some classical training games, especially when I knew that I was going to play here, because basically I didn't play any, I mean, not even training for 2 years. And then at the very last moment, I played one game, so that was pretty much all I did. I mean, in terms of classical chess, of course I was training all the time and I was working on my chess a lot, and I was playing blitz, so that was basically my preparation.
Well, take us into that training insight of, can you even get a 2700 to play you in a classical game? Would you have to pay him for his time? I mean, maybe Fabiana owes you one for your help in London, but he's your competitor here. How does that work out?
Yeah, but we are living a bit far, because I'm living in Miami, and it's not so simple to find opponents there to play training games. But I managed to find one of my friends who helped me and decided to give me some training opportunities.
Well, as with the World Championship, your second will remain a secret. We were all trying to guess who Fabiano's seconds were, although it wasn't very hard. But anyway, last question. I'm hoping you could save me on some research. Has there ever been a player of Cuban ancestry to win the U.S. Championship? I don't know. Maybe you can tell me. I don't think Julio Becerra ever quite did it.
I don't think so. I mean, of course, many Cuban players played in the U.S. Championship, but I don't think that that they win any time. So I could be the first.
Could be setting history. And in your first U.S. Championship, it'd be quite amazing. Good luck the rest of the way in the final three rounds.
Thank you.